Well, this is College of Art Delhi at Tilak Mark, and this is the surrounding. Well, the pandemic time is on, and so students are not here, or maybe few faculties are here. Well, I wanted to meet one faculty. Today I'll be meeting Assistant Professor Ramesh Kandagiri. And, well, this is his room, C104. Oh, I just want to have a look. This is printmaking department over there. Okay, so let's move in. As you can see, these are his works. These are the canvases. I'll show you the works closely. I will just browse through the works over here. These are his drawings. And this book, which you can see right now, is his PhD. And this is what he did for his PhD, and it's in a book format right now. Well, I'm really curious to see all these unknown corners. Studio. These are the books he has collected, and he read a lot. हेलो रमेश सर.
हाय.
या हाय रमेश कंडागरी सर. आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन. आई वुड स्टार्ट द सेशन टुडे विथ वन बेसिक क्वेश्चन. व्हाई यू वांटेड टू बिकम एन आर्टिस्ट? लाइक व्हाट इंस्पायर्ड यू टू बिकम एन आर्टिस्ट, टू बी एन आर्टिस्ट? व्हाई?
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी टेल यू दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन.
थैंक यू.
एंड ऑल्सो एन इंटरेस्टिंग वन. Why I have chosen to become an artist?
Right.
In fact, I have never had any choice.
Okay.
My parents, it is my good fortune that my parents understood that I am becoming artist.
Okay.
I am right becoming an artist.
Right from your childhood?
Right from my childhood.
Okay.
Because at times I was recovered from nearby forest.
Mm-hmm.
When I was in nursery.
Okay.
I used to just abscond from my class.
Okay.
And I was found sitting there in the woods.
Okay.
I used to enjoy the savage.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Because maybe the savage in me.
Okay.
Was finding its home there.
Okay.
So I believe, not believe, I know that we all are savage.
Mm-hmm. So
I cannot escape from the fact that we are all savage.
Okay.
And so far as the question of choice,
mm-hmm,
and not choice.
Okay.
So I said that there was no choice burden on me,
mm-hmm,
because my parents carried a talent in them.
Okay.
My father is a retired engineer.
Okay.
And my mother is a homemaker.
Okay.
My mother used to prepare paper mache objects.
Okay.
And used to paint on that.
Right.
And she used to sing also.
So where you used to stay? Where used to be part of? In which part of India you used to stay?
We belong to Andhra Pradesh.
Fine.
But we never happened to be staying for a long time there.
Okay.
As my father is a retired railway engineer.
Okay.
Civil engineer.
So he used to move around also, like?
Yeah, we transferred from Bengal to Bihar. So
okay.
in that flux, I was born in Bihar.
Okay. Okay.
So
right.
In childhood, I was given to write something on the slate,
mm-hmm,
but I used to draw.
Instead of writing, you used to draw?
Yeah.
Right?
My mother says that I was five,
uh-huh,
during that time,
uh-huh,
when I used to scribble.
Okay.
So, if I force myself to remember that erstwhile,
mm-hmm,
time,
mm-hmm,
I find that I used to scribble and I used to enjoy.
Right.
I used to scribble everywhere,
right,
on the walls also,
right,
home, in the interior walls.
Okay.
And when the time, like every situations,
mm-hmm,
every situations that oppressed me,
mm-hmm,
every situations that oppressed me forced me to become an artist.
Wow. Okay.
And okay. For everybody's kind information, the theory of avant-garde is itself kind of, you know, secession from the suppressing institutions.
Okay. Okay.
If a person, if an individual is potent enough to secede from the suppressing institutions around, and then she or he is receiving shocks from that situations.
Right.
And when after digesting those shocks, she or he is processing those shocks and shocking the society with aesthetic wisdom.
Okay.
That is the, you know, avant-garde actually. So I am that avant-garde.
Okay.
Because every second I am living the moment.
Okay.
And I am constantly bored by myself.
Okay. Okay.
I feel that every second I am dying.
Okay.
And I am taking birth again.
Wow.
And in that process, anything that comes in is not an issue actually. People take those issues as a reality, but they are not the reality.
Okay.
They are the symptoms of reality. And those symptoms I collect.
Okay.
I collect those symptoms and I live those, you know, I live with those symptoms.
Okay.
And I paint with those symptoms.
Okay. So you like, from your childhood, you wanted to be an artist, and where you had taken
I never wanted to be an artist.
Okay.
I never wanted to be an artist because I never knew what is an artist is.
Okay. Okay.
it was so that what I was doing was an art only.
Okay.
And the way I used to live,
that's people, also art.
The time thrashed me to a situation which is called artist.
Okay.
You know, I never knew the definition of an artist.
But you went to college to take your formal education?
Yes,
art?
I did.
So why to a college? Like, see, this is an interesting question because I'm putting the question to you because you just said that you never wanted to be an artist.
Yeah.
So why you have taken the admission in a college?
Yeah.
Like then it will be like you will be following a systematic pattern.
Definitely.
An academic pattern.
Definitely.
Right? So why into that?
Yeah, I'll tell you. It was during the childhood time. I mean, it was when I was 16 or 17.
Okay.
That was 1979.
Okay.
When I came down with asthma and developed respiratory problems.
Okay.
And I could not breathe.
Okay.
So out of much difficulties, I could survive. But then I had lot of medicine allergies. Then I was sent to a nature cure hospital.
Okay.
There I was...
What age you were?
It was...
17 years?
Yes, 16, 17
16
years.
Or 17.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
It was in 19... I still remember it was 1980s.
80s. Okay.
When I was admitted to Nature Cure Hospital at Gorakhpur.
Okay.
Called Arogya Mandir.
Okay.
It was run by Vitthal Das Modi, a very efficient naturopath.
Okay.
I learned a lot from them. So
that was your life-changing moment?
Yeah, it was. It was. Because till then, I used to, you know, be very kind of melancholy ridden. I used to crave for the life.
Okay.
I used to crave for the life.
Okay.
And then, one fine day, I was admitted in the hospital. Then, there I did fast. 14 days fast I did.
14 day fast?
Yeah.
Okay.
I did 14 days fast with that clay and water treatment.
Okay.
And then I was cured by 4 months I was there. I was cured.
Okay.
Then when I was just having a walk, evening walk there, suddenly one person came around me.
Okay.
And he saw me sketching. during my upvas time.
Acha.
Fast time.
Okay.
So he came to me and said, show me your drawings.
Uh-huh.
I thought, who is this?
And
you know who was that person? No. He was one of the most important person in my life,
uh-huh.
who actually inspired me away
okay.
to go to Shantiniketan.
Okay.
And that was Pankaj Panwar.
Okay. Okay.
Sculptor.
Sculptor Pankaj
Panwar. Very renowned sculptor he is.
Right.
He is my senior.
Okay.
And he saw all my sketches.
Okay.
Because I used to do Devi Devataon ka tasveer. And then actors.
Okay.
And all those Hemamali, Amitabh Bachchan, Dharmendra and all those people. Then I had a piled up drawings.
Like okay. This.
He told me to go to Shantiniketan.
Uh-huh.
When I first went to Shantiniketan after being cured,
mm-hmm.
was that curing, the health that I found,
mm-hmm.
was the greatest sublime I had in my life.
Okay.
Whenever the sublime is both when you meet the death,
mm-hmm.
and you get the life. The sublime is remembered that itself.
Absolutely.
So I will
this
tell
was
you,
your more like near death experience.
Yeah, that was. I will tell you that part also.
Okay.
Because I feel that death and life has a kind of there is a very thin line,
mm-hmm.
and experience is both same.
Okay.
Because if I really understand what is death,
uh-huh.
it is blissful actually.
Okay.
Yes, because it is not different than meditation.
Okay.
Because in meditation, we die,
mm-hmm.
and be born again.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Similarly,
mm-hmm.
in life,
okay,
we should know,
mm-hmm.
the contemplation.
Okay.
Which I call occurring in the instant.
Uh-huh.
This is like being in right and now,
mm-hmm.
right here and now,
mm-hmm.
and being enlightened every second.
Okay.
Like I wrote in my diary, if you allow me, I will quote it from my diary.
Please.
That is, I will not wait for the enlightenment which I might get.
Mm-hmm.
Or I might not get tomorrow.
Okay.
But I will. I would be rather happy.
Mm-hmm.
Contemporaneously enlightened.
Okay.
Contemporaneously enlightened.
Okay.
Every second, every moment.
Every moment. Right.
Be it I am writing.
Okay.
Be it I am talking to someone.
Mm-hmm.
Be it I am walking.
Right.
Eating, doing anything in this world.
Any kind of act.
Anything.
Okay.
So I should be able to relish that.
True.
Okay. When it comes to painting,
mm-hmm.
then balle balle we have got, we are more happy because
okay.
there is no calculation, nothing.
So from there on, you went to Shantiniketan, and
yeah.
Shantiniketan, you did your bachelor's.
I did my bachelor's, but I didn't get the admission first.
Okay, first time you didn't get
first time I didn't get, because I had the portfolio which carried drawings of actors and Devi Devata,
ha, 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 ha.
Which they right away discarded.
Okay.
They said, no, this will not do.
Okay.
You have to, and that was good thing for me. They taught
okay.
me to draw from life.
From life, okay.
Yeah, and then I was so shocked that I couldn't get admission for a moment only.
Uh-huh.
But then it was learning procedure for me, and
then
I stayed back.
Then which year you got the admission?
Yeah, I stayed back and learned from
okay.
my seniors.
Okay.
And next year I applied.
In which year? Like in which
1985.
Year? 1985 you got
yeah.
the admission. Okay. So you did your bachelor's in visual art,
yeah.
BVA, right? If
BFA,
I'm correct.
BFA.
You did
yeah.
BFA. And that was for 5 years or four?
5 years.
4 years.
Not like today's.
Right.
Yeah.
That's why I'm asking. And what kind of art used to practice, or what inspired you in your college days, like in Shantiniketan? Shantiniketan is very rich in a lot of things, and the surrounding is in you are amidst nature basically.
Yeah.
The tribals are over there. So many things
so
are there.
Things.
And you have complete freedom. So what inspired you? What kind of work you used to do there? And if you remember any particular art or any particular artist who inspired you during your college days?
First of all, Rabindranath Tagore, I would say.
Okay.
Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore.
Mm-hmm.
Because being an outsider.
Okay.
Being an outsider.
Mm-hmm.
And also
mm-hmm.
that I cherished my, aspirations
mm-hmm.
to be part of the Shantiniketan.
Mm-hmm.
If only I could be able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But it was so surprising. It's a full of surprise and ecstasy for me.
Okay.
When I got the admission in Shantiniketan.
Okay.
And I was so happy. And my all dreams were, they came true.
Uh-huh.
And then I liked Shantiniketan because of another important thing, that is, it really gave me the reflective image of what freedom I had been thinking about.
Okay.
What freedom is called, like.
Uh-huh.
Because during the time before Shantiniketan,
uh-huh.
I was, that academic burden,
uh-huh.
That especially the examinations.
Mm-hmm.
I never took examination so seriously.
Okay.
Because I never performed examination with a kind of, now this is this, I am performing.
You have
no,
to perform.
Very
have...
casually I performed. I got good marks.
Okay.
I was always second class.
Okay.
And of course in masters I became first.
First.
Yeah.
Three. Ramesh sir, you were telling us something about your Shantiniketan part during the student life over there. So what else you can share with us?
Yeah, there are a lot of things to share actually.
Okay.
And even the whole life I spent sharing,
mm-hmm.
it will not exhaust. It is like a reservoir.
Yeah, never ending story. Huh?
Never ending reservoir.
Okay.
Never exhaustible reservoir.
True, true.
Means Shantiniketan has given me the energy.
Okay.
Which is inexhaustible.
Okay.
I am thankful to each and every thing of Shantiniketan.
Okay.
Beginning from Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore.
Uh-huh.
And all my benevolent seniors.
Okay.
All my talented and, wonderful seniors.
So who
lovely
were,
seniors.
Who were your faculties over there at that time?
And faculties, of course. Yes.
Who were your faculties over
yeah,
there?
Yeah, faculties were... I was fortunate to have Jogen Chaudhary.
Wow! Jogen
and,
Chaudhary.
Yeah, Jogen Chaudhary was my... Jogenda was my direct teacher.
Okay.
And by that time...
You reported directly to him?
Yes.
Okay, as a student.
I used to be... we were to academically report to him.
True, true.
And
okay.
Of course we have... We had Professor K.G. Subramanian.
Okay.
He was Professor Emeritus by that time.
Mm-hmm.
He retired and then was invited.
Right.
And we used to go. I used to be scared to go to him before.
Okay.
His wonderful way of diction
mm-hmm.
and oration
mm-hmm.
has really inspired me.
Okay.
And I. Used to think okay, whether he's why don't people call him a philosopher?
He was a philosopher mm-hmm.
and a philosophy again is a kind of alter ego for me.
Okay.
I find philosophy constantly checking me
mm-hmm.
giving me the reality check.
Okay.
And making me to grow.
Okay.
And then I had lot of wonderful classmates.
Mm-hmm.
We used to enjoy like anything. But okay. One thing my seniors used to tell me
uh-huh.
is you enjoy whatever you want. Because if you come to Shantiniketan,
right.
if you have come to Shantiniketan and you never know how to enjoy,
uh-huh.
means you are lost then. You have done nothing at all.
You have to open up your soul, you have to
exactly.
absorb the yeah. things over there.
And it was a kind of vardaan for me. Getting such a seniors. Who is asking me to do hodang and do, you know, all the mischiefs.
Total freedom with
them.
Okay.
But very astonishingly,
uh-huh.
when somebody is asking me to do mischief,
uh-huh.
I forget how to do mischief.
Okay.
I become non-mischievous.
Okay.
So, there was a reason for that.
Uh-huh.
How can you do mischief in Shantiniketan, yaar?
Okay.
But such a beautiful atmosphere,
uh-huh.
it is asking me to come.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it is asking me to come and, you know, be just contemplative.
Mm-hmm.
So when you are contemplative, how can you do mischief?
True.
Because mischief is the lack of contemplation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know?
Right.
Or we can say a true mischiever,
mm-hmm.
you know, a true mischievous person
uh-huh.
is the most validated candidate for the meditation.
Okay.
So am I.
Okay.
Ek number ka khurafati aadmi wahan jaake seedha ban gaya.
Okay.
And then started my life here.
Okay. And so you stayed there for 5 years.
I stayed there for 6 years.
For 6 years you were there.
Because I took 1 year break.
Okay.
Yeah. And yeah, it has a connection with one of my childhood memory.
Mm-hmm.
Childhood memory was like you were talking about how what inspired me.
Inspired me to be an artist.
Artist, and it has a connection with what inspired me to think about abstraction.
Abstraction.
Yes.
Okay, I'll come to that part also. Like, yeah, I know. It's a long part, but yes, please start with this.
Should I?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was some time back when I was 7 years old.
Okay.
And I went with my uncle to have a haircut
uh-huh.
in a saloon
mm-hmm.
when I saw Gaitonde's painting.
Okay.
Being framed
mm-hmm.
and Raja Ravi Verma's painting being framed and kept on the wall. They were hanging.
You're talking about the saloon. Saloon had that.
Saloon, yes.
Wow.
They were hung side by side.
Wow.
Maybe that juxtaposition was to make a history in me.
Mm-hmm.
And that.
Gaitonde and Ravi Verma both.
And see the contrast. You know?
Absolutely.
One. Which is abstract.
It's a total contrast.
I never know what you knew what his abstraction was.
Uh-huh.
I just asked my uncle. To my astonishment, I liked the both.
Okay.
One did not had any figure. Another mm-hmm. had all the paraphernalia of representational, representationality.
True.
I asked my uncle. My uncle said, maybe he was, flaunting his knowledge.
Uh-huh.
He said, the one which you see without any figure,
mm-hmm.
okay, that is the modern art.
Okay.
And the
so
one
that was
which
your
is,
first initiation into art?
Yeah.
And
the one which you see without...
with figure.
Which you see with figure
mm-hmm.
is the real art.
Okay.
So, no, it's a dichotomy.
Dichotomy, absolutely.
A knowledge given with a paradox.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And that paradoxical knowledge...
Right.
...had sparked the flame in me.
True. Okay.
And I grew up with that paradox.
Okay.
So that's why philosophy attracts me.
Okay.
Because philosophy is never a solution.
Mm-hmm.
Philosophy will always keep your intellect on and on and on. So you should be able to question again and again.
True.
Even to yourself.
True. Right.
Which is why, at times I feel A true avant-garde is the one who even rebels himself. If I'm a boring person,
right?
You know, constantly we are becoming boring actually. I understand that because it is our tactics. It is our regressive tactics to validate ourselves even despite our being bored, boring. You know, that habit of repeatedly practiced habit of practicing that tactics of validating ourselves despite being boring has finally made India so insipid. In fact, Indian understanding so insipid because any civilization once had, you know, gone high and higher,
right,
is bound to ripe, and whatever is ripe is bound to decay,
right,
and whatever is decaying is bound to, you know, slow, you know, it will become a loath and it will become a dead body.
Okay.
And that will stink.
True.
So when forcefully we put medicines to keep that, you know, dead body mummified. Okay.
Right.
So our culture has been mummified.
Okay.
Our culture has been mummified.
Okay.
So this I am talking in context of abstraction actually.
Abstraction.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because when I grew up with that paradox, and then that was the day, and after that many things changed. I became adolescent, and then I told you about that illness.
Okay. Right. Right.
And during that illness, actually one miracle happened with me.
Okay.
That I never allowed myself to die so easily. I never. I'm a fighter from the beginning. And illness had taught me to fight.
Okay.
Earlier I used to fight with my illness. Today I fight with systemic hooligans.
Okay. Okay. Quite interesting.
Systemic hooligans.
Yeah, quite interesting. Okay. Term you have used.
Yeah. And these hooligans are everywhere.
Right. True. True.
They are in the Chaddam Vesh.
Right.
They are in disguise.
They are chameleons.
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 Yes. And if you are a fighter, you will have a reason to fight. That's it. Simply. And
right.
Yes, this paradox had given me to question everything.
Everything.
Even to myself.
So your initiation into abstraction was from the college days, was it after passing out from the college, from Shantiniketan? Was Shantiniketan the place where you practiced, where you have explored this option or this medium, or like this kind of thought process, the kind of abstraction you are doing right now? Where did it start? It started during your college time?
Yeah, that's a very, very, very intense question. This is very intense question. I think it is all enveloping question. Actually, before that, I must tell you that when I was in my sick bed, I was there on my sick bed for 2 years.
Right.
And during the afternoons, I used to, when everybody used to sleep, I used to search.
Okay.
You know. When you have lost hopes on something, your sense of hope actually does not die.
Okay.
It does not die. It goes on finding its, you know, alter ego.
Okay.
Somewhere or other way.
Okay.
I used to find, I used to search something, but that searching has given me a very important thing. That is, I found those books of European paintings and Russian paintings in my father's,
okay,
in my father's box,
okay,
old box,
okay,
I discovered those European paintings book and Russian paintings book. I was so marveled at those pictures.
Okay.
I used to copy them.
Okay.
I used to copy those realistic figures and realistic landscapes and all.
Okay.
With a poster color, because I never knew what oil.
Okay.
So through poster color, I used to bring the effect of oil. And I used to draw.
Okay.
So I mastered the realistic drawing before I could enter Shantiniketan.
Okay.
By the time I was entering Shantiniketan, I had already mastered the realistic drawing.
Okay.
So somebody told me that, my seniors told me that you have to be practicing one particular composition and you will be asked to draw, paint that. So I used to be in Andal that time. There I went
Andal.
To Andal.
Okay.
There I went to a potter and I paid him to sit for me and I practiced him. And the same thing I drew in the Shantiniketan entrance exam.
Okay.
And this was a tempo that this realism, this realism in fact, academic realism.
Yeah.
We must say academic realism, because
true.
All academies are forcing this realism into you.
True.
So much so that by the end of the day, you might be confused that is that all? No, I feel
right
that this entire art academy
right
is a corridor with both side rooms.
Right.
And there is only one door out there.
Okay.
At the end.
Okay.
You enter in one room, there is still life being taught. Another room, there is a
life drawing.
Life drawing is being taught.
Right.
Another room, there is portrait.
Portrait.
Other room, blah, blah.
Okay.
And last room, there will be a big window from where you will be taught landscape. From window. The landscapes are taught from the window.
Right.
So, this is funny. I wanted the landscape to be taught in the open air.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Then, Shantiniketan. It was like that.
True.
And you feel that, you know, you are actually in the landscape.
You are within the landscape.
Yeah, you are in the landscape.
You are in the landscape.
Okay.
Right.
And then, there are people who, in the process of, you know, having the academic degree or learning, forget that they should also take their souls, which are captured in one of these rooms. They kept their souls here only. With a body only, they went out.
Okay.
And they are stagnated somewhere, you know, with a figuration. I'm not saying that figuration is wrong, my dear. Figuration itself is an abstraction. Because to express anything creatively, you have to be using abstraction.
Okay.
You know, abstraction is compulsory. It is not something that you first do realistic, then one day you will be an abstract painter. No. That is a wrong notion. And the notions that first you have to learn Greek art and then this art and that art. This is also a post-colonial, colonial and post-colonial mentality.
Okay.
Which I object.
Okay.
If I had to run an institution as an authority and a educationist.
Right.
I will never force any student to take a, you know, to start with the so-called academic. I will give her and him complete freedom to start from anywhere.
Start from anywhere.
Yes.